Howdy, y'all. Welcome back. In this video, we're going to finish up with our discussion of using logical data in MATLAB. Here, we're moving on to the fourth reason that we use logical data, which is to address and find special entries in arrays. We're going to see some examples of that idea in action. Let's start with our first example where we're going to store a random integer matrix, actually pseudo random numbers, but don't worry. We'll use the randi function to do this. We'll say that the values of each individual entry run from 1 all the way up to 20 on the maximum, uniformly distributed in our choice. And we'll say that this is a 6x6 matrix. When we run that line of code, MATLAB produces that random integer matrix. Notice that there is one value of 1, there's a value of 20, and then all of the other values are between that. If we run that again, we get a different matrix. And in fact, each time we run it, MATLAB is going to produce a random distribution with different values involved. Let's go ahead and run that one more time. So here we've got this random integer matrix with values between 1 and 20 uniformly distributed. We're going to run some tests on this matrix using logical data and relational operators as we've seen in previous videos. In this example, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a logical array that stores the locations of the big addresses in logical format. So let's go ahead and say that we want to find all locations in R that are bigger or equal to 14. Notice MATLAB produces a logical array. If we were to actually find the locations of R where these things are located, MATLAB is going to actually produce for us all of the locations where that holds true. So notice the first one is 14. 14 happens, looks like this is done by column. So MATLAB runs through the columns. Second column produces 14, 14. Down to the third column, another 14. Fourth column, 17, 15, 20, and that's that list. One thing that we could do is actually leverage this to zero these out. So what if we were to set a new variable, let's call it temp, and we'll call this zeros, and we'll say that this has 6x6. And then what we're gonna do is set temp of L big equal to the values of R at L big. So this is going to go into the individual values of R where they are larger than or equal to 14. And then also the corresponding locations in temp and set those things equal. Notice what we've done is we've now picked off the larger elements in R and placed them in the exact same locations in our matrix temp. Now if we were to take R minus temp, what we've now done is zeroed out all the large elements in temp. We could do the same functionality on the small end. So let's go ahead and call this L small, and we'll set this to be a logical array where R is less than 5. And then what we could do is the same thing, temp of L small is gonna actually equal to R of L small. And then of course we could zero out all the places where the big ones hold. So let's go back into temp, and then everywhere there was a big element of this, let's set that equal to 0. So now we're just picking off the small elements. Now if we go back to R and subtract away temp, this would get rid of all the small elements that satisfy the condition that I want. Of course, I could be more laser-like in my precisions. Let's go ahead and find all the values where R is equal to 14, or R is equal to 15, or R is equal to 16. We'll store that in a logical array called L. Now, if I were to take R of L, notice that indeed I have 3 14s, 1 15, and 1 16. And then what I could do is actually say, please set R of L equal to 0. In other words, go into my original matrix, find the values where there are 14s, 15s, or 16s, and then change those values to 0. That's exactly what that call does. Let's take a look at another example to see how this thing functions. So we'll go ahead and create a capital matrix M. We'll call this magic of 5. Notice if we typed help magic, this creates an n by n matrix constructed from integers 1 through n squared with equal row, column, and diagonal sums. In other words, each of the numbers in magic 5 counts from 1 to 25, and if we sum the rows or the columns or the diagonals, we get a constant number. Let's go ahead and use logical indexing to strategically eliminate some of the values of this particular matrix. Let's suppose that we wanted to create a logical matrix from M that focuses on the big numbers. Specifically, we'll set this everywhere where m is greater than or equal to 7, we'll do this. So now all of the values that are greater than or equal to 7 in m, we store that. Now let's use that to do a different version. So let's go ahead and zero out everything that's not big in this. So for everything that is in the logical matrix storing the big addresses, let's set those to 0. Notice MATLAB takes everything that is not greater than or equal to 7 and sets it equal to 0, leaving only the big numbers left over. We could also do this for both big and small numbers. So let's set m equal to magic 5, which is what we did earlier. Now we'll create a logical matrix from m, and we're going to target locations that store entries that are above 6 and below 19. So when the logical ones are in those locations, that tells me that these values are in between 6 and 19. So they're either 7, 8, all the way up to 18. That's what we see up here. When I then look at m of lm, this is logical array indexing, I get a list of values that are between 6 and 19. And then what I could do is actually say, please set everything in m that does not satisfy the condition equal to 0, which means I get rid of everything 6 or below and 19 and above, leaving everything in between intact. This is one of the main utilities of logical variables. They allow us to target individual matrix entries by doing tests and then using those tests to go to the position in those matrices and then do work in those positions. We'll see more about that as we go forward. Community challenge for today is, in the comment section below, write your answers to the following questions. How does logical indices show up in practice in MATLAB? You can write your own answers or, of course, link to other people that have described that very well. I also always welcome your comments, questions, and concerns. Thank you so much for your attention, and I'll see you in the next video.